Lisa Su, you gave a really strong set of predictions and kind of growth outlook for this market in AI accelerators. In real terms, right now in this quarter and the quarter gone, where does that confidence come from? What data points are you relying on?
Yeah, Ed, you know, we look at AI, you know, when I look at the potential of AI, it is really the, you know, single most important, technology innovation over the last 50 years. So AI has so much potential to, you know, change the way our businesses work, to change our personal productivity, to really change the way we do research and a whole bunch of things. From our standpoint, we see the AI TAM growing to upwards of, you know, $400 billion by 2027. I think from an AMD standpoint, you were at our launch, Ed, in December. It was a great coming out party for the AMD, you know, AI capabilities, and it's gone really well. I think our customer interactions, our product qualifications, our ramp have gone really well. So yes, we were able to update, some of our numbers this past week.
I think a lot of folks focused on that ramp and how it went in the quarter. You know, you exceeded the $400 million that you told me about at that event. So it's $3.5 billion of sales this year for MI300. What's interesting here is kind of your ramp relative to what's happening on the supply side. And I wondered how big a factor supply will be in matching or beating that number in 24.
Yeah, absolutely, Ed. This is the fastest product ramp, in our history. So, you know, we exceeded our numbers in Q4, over 400 million. We're going to grow into Q1, and we update our full year forecast from 2 billion to 3.5 billion. The way we think about that is that's a customer demand statement. So that is customers that we've engaged in, who have made commitments to us, who have placed orders with us. We're planning for a much larger number as it relates to the supply chain. This is what we should do. We always plan for success. My view is it's still very, very early in the innings for AI accelerators, and particularly for MI300. But this is an opportunity for us to, you know, continue to build a major growth driver as we work with our top customers on their AI plans.
And Lisa, just to clarify in layman's terms, so your expectation is the supply available to you from a volume perspective in 24 will be greater than the $3.5 billion in demand that you feel confident in right now?
That's absolutely right, Ed.
So you and I talked about this kind of change in what's happening in the use case of AI accelerators, moving from a predominantly training-focused environment to inference. And I think I'm right in saying you're confident that AMD is going to play a key role in that inference part. But there's also the question of when the psychology of the customer changes. And I think one question that one of the analysts covering the stock had, Pierre Ferragu, was on the show with me earlier, is when do the customers commit? When do they basically say, we've got good visibility on our training and now inference demands over a multi-year horizon?
Yeah, I think, Ed, as always, when we're dealing with, deep partnerships like we have, across, the hyperscalers, at our event, we mentioned, Microsoft, Oracle, Meta, all committing to adopt MI300. We really plan multi-year roadmaps as well as, capabilities. So I'm super happy with how things have gone. I think key in all this is the devil is in the details. The engineering is really important. We've made tremendous amount of progress over the last couple of months. You've heard directly from, one of our customers, Microsoft, Kevin Scott, talked about the work that they've been doing with their, most important workloads around, ChatGPT and its capabilities. We have confidence that from a performance standpoint, we can be very competitive. And from that standpoint, the customer conversations are multi-year, multi-generational conversations. We certainly have good visibility in terms of exact orders for the next couple of quarters. But more importantly, we're planning, how is this market going to grow and how do we grow together, going forward?
Lisa, where are we at with PC and everyday server demand?
Well, it's a good question. I think we've gone through some ups and downs in the PC market and the traditional server market. I think what we saw is a nice recovery into the second half of the year. So we were very pleased with our performance, frankly, in traditional server in the second half of the year. We grew strong double digits. And more importantly, what we see is our products are getting a lot of traction. So our Genoa or our Zen 4 product line has ramped really nicely. As we go into 2024, my expectation is that the server market will grow and that we will grow significantly faster than the market, just given the strength of our product portfolio. And there are a lot of data center refreshes, going on. So that's the server market. Ed, you also asked about the PC market. I think the PC market also recovered nicely in the second half of the year. In general, the PC market tends to be a little bit seasonal. So the second half is stronger than the first half. And then we see that also in 2024. But we also see the PC market growing, let's call it low single digits, here in 2024. And within that, the very exciting part about the PC market is AI PCs, which we think can grow substantially faster.
Lisa, the tension in the share reaction is exactly that. Enthusiasm for MI300 and concern about a recovery in end markets elsewhere. How do you see the tension between those two product lines, essentially, for you evolving in this current period and throughout 24?
I'm actually really excited about 24. I start every year always quite optimistic, but I look at 24 as, such an important year for us. I think, 23 was when we established ourselves as, a key AI contender. I think 24, we're going to show just how capable and how much, AI is now part of, really the entire AMD story. And in terms of the other markets, look, I like PCs. I think traditional server is going to recover nicely as well. And, put aside some of the temporal things. We've said that, revenue will be more second half weighted in 24. I think we feel really good about the setup going into the next few quarters, given the strength of our product portfolio and also, the great, customer partnerships that we have.
AMD CEO Lisa Su, it's great to catch up. Great to have you on Bloomberg Television. And as always, I love talking chips. So thank you for your time.